for the introduction. So, hi everybody, good afternoon. So, let me take you through the journey. So, basically, ElasticRun, we were established in 2016, and we are a technology-driven network transforming multiple industries. So, some more details about our company. So, basically, we are transforming multiple industries. We started with e-commerce companies where we are helping our customer to connect the last mile delivery and the first mile connect for our customers. Then we also got into distribution of FMCG products, FMCG and commodity. There we are actually spread across India, looking mostly in rural distribution and also into getting into urban distribution. We are also working on providing credit line to our customers for this distribution business, where we are partnering with banks and distributors. Then again, we are also there where we are helping manufacturers to get their goods transferred to the warehouses, where we are taking care of their full truckloads. Our trucking partners are helping us to do that. So moving on to the next slide. So if you see, right, we are around spread across more than 370 plus cities. This is across tier one, tier two, tier three cities in India. Most of them connected, managed centrally via our Pune head office. And it is all done via technology. And we have around 100,000 plus partners, which help us on various things. There are partners who help us with our manpower requirements. There are partners who help us with our transportation requirements. Then there are partners who help us with our warehouses, our stations, managing them. We are managing the end-to-end life cycle of this distribution, right? So everything is done across India via our technology platforms that we have built. So this was related to ElasticRun and how in which business areas we are in. We are heavily dependent on open source. Now this open source, majorly the open sources that we are using, definitely it's ERPNext and Frappe. Apart from that, we are using Kafka, Node.js, Java, Kubernetes, Docker, the database being MySQL, PG, right? We are, and the list goes on. But there is a definitely a major contribution that we have via Frappe and ERPNext. So this journey started somewhere around, again, as we established our business, we were evaluating certain products in the market, and we were looking at package products that are available for HR management. Then we were looking for some package products for expense management. We did some trials. We found that we are going to face a bottleneck once we want to do more enhancements. We wanted a very flexible framework, a very flexible product, which will allow us to do customizations as and when it is required. Our company processes were also not very robust at that time. It was going to grow as the number of employees increased. So we stumbled around Elastic, ERPNext, right, and Frappe. We evaluated it. We found it was very impressive. We thought, let's start with few use cases. Started with expense management and employee data. We kept on working on version 7 for a year. And then finally, we decided, and when we thought that we wanted to move to, we wanted to keep ElasticRun working on ERPNext for our corporate ERP. And these were some of the challenges that we had. For the first one being, if you see, right, we are across multiple businesses, whether it is e-commerce, whether it is distribution, whether it is our trucking platform. Every business is generating huge number of financial transactions, right? And that time we had Tally. So all this information was manually fed into Tally by our accounting team, right? They were doing a humongous job of heavy lifting data from here and pushing into Tally, all manual entry system, correct? And we were looking at a central ERP system where we could do everything and we could just remove Tally from the picture. The another big area that we wanted to automate and digitize was our HR processes, right? And we didn't want two different ERPs to do, one for HR and one for accounts. And then how do we make sure that we do a mix and match of the master data across all of them? So this is where we decided, let's move on to the latest version of ERPNext. Version 10 was the version at that time. And we pulled in Pavan Mehta from OpenE Technologies. He helped us with evaluating our current system and how do we move on to version 10. How do we define our master data? When I say master data, how do we define our chart of accounts? What all should be there, right? We had a chart of account in Tally, but then do we migrate it straight forward, or do we need to prune it further? We need to make it more detailed, right? ERPNext comes with the default chart of accounts, but then we had a lot of more details to be added to it, right? And so that was one key information for which we spent a lot of time debating around. Pawan helped us to close that chart of accounts structure. Then we also had our supplier master data. How do we transfer the data from our old version 7 ERP to our version 10? The documents and everything, the transitioning was smooth, but then we ourselves had structural changes in our documents that we prepared in the new version, right? So we did all this migration, we mapped everything over there, created employee master data like designations, departments, and branches, and all those information, our item master, right? So these all the critical master data that is required to run our P2P process, to run our HR processes, was finalized. And in 2018, we went with a complete new version of ERPNext and did a corporate-wide rollout and started using this as thinking that this is our sole ERP that we are going to use for all our internal process of Elastic Run. And started figuring out what are the gaps, what are the processes that we still have to figure out and post it. With this version 10, we added a couple of more features. We enabled procure to pay process, where the complete PO, PR, invoice, and payment process was enabled. Then we established our master data. Performance management, this is related to employee performance management. We also had to integrate with our e-commerce business. So now, this was our first business that we had started with. This was our corporate ERP. So there was data getting generated in the e-commerce business. We did a integration by doing just plain API calls. As we know, right, ERPNext has doc types where it gives by default CRUD operations as APIs, and you can call it from any third-party application. Our e-commerce application was a Java-based application, but we were able to successfully integrate with ERPNext and able to push data into the system. So in 2019 and 20, we moved from version 10 to version 11. This was again a major boost. We found that version 11 was having a lot of performance improvements, lot of new functionalities getting introduced. So we decided to migrate our version 10 to version 11. It was a very smooth migration. Took us some time for just a Python upgrade, since version 11 was a new version of Python, right? But then we were able to do it in 15-20 days, and we were able to finish that. Along with this version 11, we enabled a lot of key features. If you see, right, we had expense management, master data, procure to pay, and other things. But the things that we enabled were the bank reconciliation systems, the management information system, the sales processing completely, the payments part of it, the fixed asset management, everything that we added newly into this version, and making sure that most of the processes are digitized. Fixed asset management being the major one. Version 11 had a lot of features related to auto asset creation and other things. We utilized all of them and digitized our complete asset register in ERPNext. We also enabled payments through bank, where we did a customization. We wanted to have a real-time IMPS payment, right? We integrated ourselves with ICICI via a intermediate batch processing, which was in Pantahoe Kettle, and we were able to do that payment as well. So now everything, starting from just punching a PO, giving an advance, making the payment, everything happens within a fraction of minutes. No manual intervention required once the approvals of the invoices are done, right? Again, we also worked on integrating our distribution business, which by 2019 was taking a shape, and it was a good amount of transactions were getting generated from distribution operations and both from e-commerce last mile operation. And this is the year where we worked on making Tally obsolete, just keeping it as a backup and moving completely on ERPNext. So this is the year where we moved all our, we tried and make sure that 2019 and 2020 data gets closed in our corporate ERP, and we move some data from Tally back into ERPNext so that we don't have to refer to Tally again, right? And as we move in the current year, which added a integration component, this was a very important component that we added. It was built on top of Kafka, and it was built because we had a lot of business applications we wanted to integrate with our corporate ERP. Now the purpose for integration was multiple. First of all, how do we make payments? How do we capture all the purchases and receipts so that my financial statements that get generated from the corporate ERP are near real time, right? Accounts team don't have to go and log in into all these applications. They can just do it through the central ERP. So we got everything connected on a real time basis via our custom integration, right? And here also we have used Frappe, which is just a wrapper on top of Kafka. Frappe is just used as a data store. And again, with Kafka, we integrated all of them. So if you see all our business platform, whether it is e-commerce, whether it is distribution, transportation, credit, everything is running around and pushing data into corporate ERP. Even these platforms, most of these, whether it is distribution, whether it is transportation platform or credit platform, they are mini ERP Next instances. Some of them Frappe instances, some of them ERP Next instances, some of them custom software. But we were able to integrate everything via our corporate ERP and enable all these huge set of features that we were able to take advantage of, right? And this is how our journey went from 2016 to 2000 in the current year. And we are still going further. We are still getting a list of features which are still not digitized. We are enabling it, checking whether they are there in ERP Next. If not, then enabling it as a custom feature. If they are there, just looking at it and making sure that they suit to our requirements. Or if customization required, we do some minor customization and start using it. So if you see, right, ERP Next has added, acted as a catalyst in the whole Elastigram technology journey. So you would have seen our 3 years journey, and ERP Next was at the very core, this being our corporate ERP. And how we were able to do it, right? It's very developer friendly. The underlying Frappe framework allowed our developers at Elastigram to roll out business specific customizations. Now, maybe you might be asking, what are those customizations that we worked on, right? Which was not there in ERP Next. Some of them being, again, this customization being very business specific for Elastigram. So they are reconciliations, payment processings, MIS financial reporting, petty cash claims, travel applications, employee performance and allocations, property contract management. So there was a lot of flavor that was related to Elastigram and hence the customization. But then again, it was on top of Frappe, everything end-to-end built, deployed on Frappe. So thanks a lot, ERP Next and Frappe. I think it rocks and it helped us roll out all these features in such a short duration, basically. Again, since the business of Elastigram is growing at a very faster pace every year, right, twice, thrice the amount, we definitely needed our platforms to be scalable. Now, as you know, right, Elastic ERP Next gets deployed as a monolithic platform, correct? But then the underlying architecture is very modular. So what we did was each of these component, right, it helped us to containerize them by Docker and then orchestrate that using Kubernetes. And it's completely cloud native, cloud agnostic manner. So that helped us to scale our platform to the growing volume of transactions that we are able to handle. And our corporate ERP being the central repository, getting transactions from all these three business lines centrally, right? And making sure that everything runs 24/7, right? And it is scale by demand, scale on demand. And Kubernetes is helping us scale that as and when we require that. But last but not the least, I would like to end with basically, we can start, if we really want to utilize ERP Next for any of our businesses, right? We can start with small, do some small customization, see whether it suits your requirement or not, right? And then start growing. If you see in our journey as well, we moved from small features, then started adding more of them, then took a decision. Yes, we want to stick to ERP Next. We don't want to evaluate any other product. Let's start adding more and more features. Let's get team involved on that. Let's users get accustomed to the ERP Next UI, basically, correct? And in our case, our account team was very helpful. They moved from Tally to ERP Next completely in a phase of 6 months or so. Basically, they were accustomed. And I think right now they are liking it a lot. And they really feel that if it would have been Tally, they have not been able to take so much data and able to generate all our financial information from there. It all helped because Frappe being a very comprehensive and flexible framework, it helped us a lot. In the end, ERP Next is awesome.